riots, the fires, the looting continuing tonight, and some say it is actually getting worse.
You're white, you don't belong here tonight.
Images of arson and rioting engulfing Los Angeles in 1992 remain vivid in the minds of many Americans, sparked by the acquittal of four LAPD officers who brutally beat a black motorist. The violence underscored simmering racial tensions and widespread distrust of the city's police.
This is where it all got started. We're on the street where Rodney King was beaten more than 20 years ago by several police officers. The video, which showed the extreme violence, was shown worldwide, and it was one of the sparks which touched off an inferno throughout the city.
Today, the area near the beating looks different, but many of the same concerns about police violence remain.
Brutality is one thing, and you know, and use of force is another.
It is not just the violence, but the sense of justice being denied, which helped the rage boil over.
The LAPD historically in black communities has been the poster agency for everything wrong with policing in America.
While the country's third largest police department claims it has reformed in the past two decades, they are still under fire for their lack of accountability.
I'm still seeing a tendency on the part within the LAPD not to punish officers.
We're at the intersection of Normandy and Florence, known as ground zero for the LA uprising. News footage showed a brutal display of chaos and anger, which had been brewing for some time. Now, some of the residents here that we spoke to say that some things have improved in the neighborhood.
Right now, we have here better than ever, safer than ever.
But another look at this intersection also shows that many of the conditions which led up to the riots are still very present.
I absolutely think that the city could erupt again. There's continued police brutality, continued repression.
Tiffany Wallace saw the unrest as a child, and as an adult, is troubled by a slumping economy, not just in Los Angeles, but across the U.S. It's only a matter of time, she thinks, before impoverished communities again rise up in anger.
I'm hoping that if there's going to be some type of unrest that happens, that it's productive, that we have people allying together, not burning down stores in our community.
Back in 1992, this empty lot here used to be filled with large stores. After the fires, it has become a trash-filled eyesore. 20 years later, this neighborhood in South Los Angeles, which is mostly comprised of blacks and Latinos, is still suffering from the ill effects of too few grocery stores and not enough jobs.
You had corporations that ran into L.A. You had every kind of government official under the sun that came to L.A. They made a lot of promises.
Promises forgotten, say residents, once the dust settled. Nationwide, black unemployment is still in the double digits, and African Americans are much more likely to end up homeless or jailed.
I would say it might be a little bit dangerous because, you know, times are harder. You know, people are struggling with the economy crashes. Jobs are hard to get, you know, people are just struggling these days.
Fertile conditions for unrest found not just in Los Angeles, but all over the U.S. today. In Los Angeles, Ramon Galindo, RT.